Okay, here we are getting set up for our brake job for our 98 Corolla. This should be the same for 98 to 2002, same body style. This is non-ABS. I haven't actually seen the ABS car yet, so I don't know what the difference is. But anyways, we got new rotors because the old ones are pretty beat up. We got our new pads. These are ceramic brake pads from Toyota. They actually come with new shims and brake lube. We got new shims there. And all that'll help reduce noise. And then we got, brake lube in case we need more. And we got our tool here to compress the piston into the brake caliper. And 17 millimeter socket. And air gun to take out the caliper mounting bracket bolts and the 14 millimeter. Oh, and a ratchet in order to get out. Here we go, good old ratchet 3/8 to get out the mounting bolts for the caliper. And there's a brake hose support bracket bolt that will take out as well. Oh, and then we also got some silicone paste to lube up the sliding pins, because these are floating style calipers and the sliding pins need to be lubricated for proper function. And that's it for the setup. I'm going to go ahead and replace the brakes. Okay, let's see. First thing I'm going to do is break that 14 millimeter bolt loose. I think it's a little rusted. This car has a little bit of rust on it from probably being somewhere where there's snow or something like that. Okay. Alright, so we got that one free, and that'll allow us to pull the caliper off and move it out of the way. Let's see. There we go. Now, breaking the bolts loose that hold the caliper on. All right. Nice thing about this setup on this Corolla is that you don't have to hold the other end with a wrench. It's locked into place, so you only need your socket. All right. So we'll just hang that caliper up out of the way for now. There we go. Alright, oh, there you go. As you can see, we got low brake pads. Alright. And they're Toyotas, but they're missing the shims, so that's no good. This is the part where it'd be good to have a big screwdriver. There we go. Pry it out. Looks like pretty good even wear. Anyhow, alright, so I'm going to take off this this bracket here. And, this is the sliding pins here. As you can see, it's getting pretty dry. There's not much left on that. I'll just go ahead and lubricate these pins before I forget. Plenty of paste there. Let's make sure that boot slides on. There we go. Get the other one. Ooh, a little bit rusty. We'll put some anti-seize on that before we put that back in. More rust. Alright. Okay, now we can get our rotor off. Pretty worn. Not too bad, but it's all rusty and nasty, so we're gonna put a new one. Okay, so I'm just cleaning up the brake hardware here. And then I'm gonna just lubricate the contact points in here where the brake pads are gonna rest to avoid any vibration and noise. Because usually that's what the brake pad noise is some sort of vibration. Okay. So we'll put some brake lube in there. Okay, and then I'm do the same thing just for good measure on the brake pads. The original pads, these are also Toyota pads, but these look like these should be the semi-metallics. Toyota says that these are a little harder on the rotors and that the ceramic is easier. It's like it should be, well, apparently it's a softer material and doesn't eat into the rotors as much and will make your rotors last longer. So that sounds good to me. I don't know. Anyways, so lubing the contact points. These brake pads, I don't know, these don't seem to have any little warning sensors on. I don't know if that's because they're missing or because they just don't have them. So either way, that's a good reason to inspect your brake pads routinely so that you don't wear them down too far and grind up your rotors. Alright, oh, then we're also going to use, I almost forgot. Before I go further, put some anti-seize / brake lube on these bolts that mount the caliper bracket. Don't want to get those frozen up in there and be in trouble. Alright. So I'm going to get my new rotor. Try to have it open. Alright. Okay. You'll probably want to cut some of this out. So the rotor's got oil residue on it, Probably to protect it from getting rusty while it's being stored, but that's not good for the brake pads and the braking performance, so we gotta clean this up. So I'm gonna use some acetone, or you can probably use some brake parts cleaner as well. Some good solvent that'll clean up the residue. Here we go. So just want to get that off. This one's not too bad. Sometimes over time the plastic seems to stick to the rotor and make a mess. So, but this one doesn't seem to have that problem. So we'll get it good and clean. There we go. Do both sides. Alright, so now I'm going to put my rotor on. Get some of that dust and debris out of there. Alright, so I want to hold it in place, so I'm just going to put on one of the lug nuts. Just get that on there. If it would go on. Hold on, I have a solution for that. Got that rotor held in place so it's not flopping around while we're getting everything else installed. All right, so we want to get our bracket in, and I got the bolts with the anti-seize on them. That'll help them go back in more smoothly. Okay, I'll put in the pads. All right. Okay. All right, and then one more step here that we need to take is to the reason that the brake loop comes in the kit is that you're supposed to put it between the shims and the brake pads in order to avoid noise. So I'm not using the packet that came in the kit because it's just easier to use my jar of lube here. And then the brake shim should fit on nice and tight. You can see there's a notch there where it lines up into. All right. Do the same on the other side. There we go. All right, now we can put on our caliper. Well, actually, first we need to push the piston in, and you want to check the level of your brake fluid because you don't want to overflow your master cylinder. So before you do this, you want to go on top and make sure that your level is okay. And you might want to watch it as you crank this piston in. because ours is a little on the full side, so it could have a chance of overflowing. It's getting up there. I think it's gonna overflow. Somebody topped off this brake fluid. Just push it in as far as it can go, just to make sure that we can fit our caliper on with the new brake pads. It all the way in. You can just use one of the old brake pads to do that. Our boot is nice and tucked back in where it should be. So we'll get our caliper on and then just gotta line up your slide pins so that they butt up against the caliper. And we're gonna put in our bolts. Tighten these down. And you don't want to forget to put in the last bolt for your brake line. What it's doing. There we go. Okay. A little bit of tension on it, so it might be a little bit of a pain to line it up and get the thread in. There we go. Okay, now we're all done, and just before we finish, we do want to make sure we're gonna press the brake pedal a few times to build up pressure and push the piston against the brake pads, because we don't right now see we got free play, and that's gonna affect your braking. You don't want to drive away like that, so just make sure to check your level of your brake fluid, pump the pedal, and you should be good to go.